For match 19 of the Women's World Volleyball Grand Prix 1993. And what promises to be a thrilling match between Cuba and Brazil. Their first meeting in the preliminary matches. And they both come here with a record of 3 wins out of 4 matches played. And the whistle goes. Brazil will open this match. They can act in Fernando Ventura. Torino, rather. Well, pretty ominous start. Cuban's getting up. And was there a touch? Delena says there was. Yes, Sahu Brazil. What a good start for them. Bel McKenzie. Step from Izquierdo, comes back to Bel McKenzie. Good blocking from the Brazilians, but a touch on the net from Delena Loca Fileiro. They were side out, Costa Blanco with it. 1-0 Brazil in the one, leading in the open set. Great dig from the Cubans, but they can't get out. Luis Fernandez, Carvajal unable to get the rebound from the net. A little dig from Luis Fernandez. Ana Paula, if you look at the back of the Brazilian shirt, you'll notice that they actually have their Christian name. Great spike, and Luis Fernandez unable to pick that up, so Brazil with the early advantage. There you see it, 2-0. Costa Blanco, Izquierdo, the spiker. Well, we've talked long and hard about her throughout this tournament. She really does get up so well. Rather than the setter, I think I just called her the spiker. She is the setter. But, the irony being, of course, that she behaves more like a spiker at times. The reverse set, did that catch the line? Yes, says the line judge. And the serve will go back out to the Brazilians. Be taken by Patricia Shostov. Jump serve. A huge serve from her. Easily dealt with by Cabral. Lovely touch from Luis Fernandez. Shostov. And the Brazilians making a bit of a meal of that. And finally, they come back. Rocco Ferreiro there, making mistakes. Carvajal to serve then. Love 2-2. Big serve from her. And the Brazilians in trouble there. Really no coordination at all. And Fernanda Venturina knocking the ball back. 1-2. And a quick set. And up well was Marcia Regina Cunha. By Fontenia. Lots of space from the Cubans, though. Roca Ferrero in with a short serve that drops straight out, and that'll go back to the Cubans at 1-2 down. There's Roca Ferrero. Izquierdo. And she immediately gives the serve back to the Brazilians. Well, mistakes all round. Cunha, serve 2-1 in front. Brazil taking the early lead. Izquierdo, the reverse set, and the block is called long, or did it drop? Well, it dropped, so we'll see it again. Well, you can't quite see on that camera angle. Cunha with another serve, then it's 3-1. Brazilian, surprisingly, an easy time of it at the moment. Izquierdo, and that's the big one from Caballero. Was it Torre Ferreira, in fact? Well, how did she squeeze that through? Luis Fernandez. Never looks ruffled, does he? And right at the feet of Caballero from Eritrea Butziak. Going well at 3-1 in this opening set. Izquierdo for Torres Herrera, and just long. Well, she looks at the line judge. We'll get another chance to see it. And well, it looks as though, well, Well, we've got the advantage of the instant replay, and it looks as though the ball caught the back of them line. I'm sure if someone of the likes of Messrs. McEnroe or Lendorf in the tennis fraternity had been out there, we'd have had play stopped for about half an hour over that point. Cubans have won the serve back. Torres Herrera with it, and that dropped straight in. Mistake from the Brazilians. They all stopped and watched it. Rocha Falero to blame there. She pulled away and thought it was obviously going to drop long. 2-4 then. Val McKenzie. Cubans really on the offensive at the moment. Brazilian struggling to keep it in play. Great blocking again. Cabral, you can see her there. And did that go long? Long from Venturina. Well left by Luis Fernandez. So 3-4. And that drops as well. Oh dear, oh dear. A couple of disastrous mistakes from Juliana Rocha Ferrero. Can't afford to make those sort of mistakes against the Cubans. Easily read by Cabral. And that is out. Finally, the Brazilians get to leave one and they get it right. Spike from Josh DeBlanco. But that will win the service back for them. Cabral up in the centre of the net. Patricia Tosco unable to deal with it. Josh DeBlanco then, 4-4 in the opener. Luis Fernandez unable to deal with the spike from Rocha Ferrero. Rocha Ferrero making up a little bit for those two earlier mistakes on the service. And she just didn't watch it go out. She's Ana Paula Rodriguez. Well, what a disastrous start for her on her service. Val McKenzie. Still all tied up at 4 apiece. Lovely blocking from Costa Blanco and Cabral to put them 5-4 in front. If you can make a quick sketch of that and study it, you're longing to be a pro volleyballer. And that was exactly not how the spike from Wojciech. Way out. So the Cubans suddenly take a 2-point advantage, 6-4. Val McKenzie going well on her serve. Brazilians playing everything on the service now. Can they get back? Torres Herrera. Scared. Oh, here comes Luis. Huge fight to make it 7-4. Val McKenzie then, who's led the Cubans back from 3-4 down to this position. And it was a poor set by the Brazilians, but they got away with it. Olivares finding the space. And Choco with a jump serve. And immediately smashes it into the net. So the Brazilians making one or two unforced errors. A lovely block. Touch against the Brazilians. And that'll be 8-4. Not quite sure who it was signalled against, but one of the Brazilian girls touching the net. Cabral with the serve at 8-4. The Cubans running away with it at the moment. And an unfortunate touch against Luis Fernandez. Pilar Bociak there, you can see she's delighted. Cunha serves at 4-8 down. Still a reel in the Cubans at this stage. Ghetto knocked back for Cabral. Threading it. Yeah, I have a needle. Beautiful stuff from Cabral. Luis Fernandez going to hammer home this 4-point advantage, but can't make the most of it and serve straight out, looking to get right down that line. Bociak, Pilar Bociak. Ahead, having some right outside. Val McKenzie, Cunha, Going to come over to Choco, and the block is out, so the Cubans pick up another point. Rather, the Brazilians pick up another point. Filho, we'll call our Filho for argument's sake. Boggio. 5-8. Brazil trailing. Double for the Cubans, and that's going to be 6-8. Surprising couple of errors from the Cubans. They never look too ruffled, though, do they? Well, we expected a tight one between these two teams, and so far it's proven to be the case, although Costa Blanco fires in a rifle shot there. Great fight, nice set from Ischia here, though. Rodriguez and Toco are unable to deal with it, and Torres Herrera will serve for Cuba. Oh, nice tip. Lovely backward tip from Venturina, the captain. And Torres Herrera at fault there for not getting forward enough after the serve. If it's the one thing you would accuse the Cubans of, it's being almost a tad lazy at times. So confident are they. They have to serve back Costa Blanco with it. Touch against the Cubans, and the Brazilians win the service back. Ana Paula Rodriguez. Costa Blanco. Gabriel sees the space, goes for it, finds it. And wins the service back. Filho Bodziak unable to reach it. A lovely touch. Just enough weight, but even though they got their fingertips to it, it eluded the blocker. Bell McKenzie with the serve then. Still at 8-6. And another mix up on the serve from the Brazilians. Enables the Cubans to leap into a 9-6 advantage. Lovely blocking from the Cubans. The Brazilians under pressure here. And again, Carvalhal with the raised fist says, no way past me, 10-6. Cubans chugging along quite nicely. Advantage 4, 5 for the opening set, any. It's been pretty quick work so far, and there's another great block. The Brazilians are going to get it back. But the pressure is all with Carvalhal and the Cubans. And that's 11-6. Well, the Brazilians going to call another timeout now. No, they don't. Well, they've gone against what I said was a principle of not letting them get more than 3 or 4 points in front. Well, they didn't need to because Bell McKenzie has hit the serve too long. The Cubans won't be unduly worried. 6-11 they lead. Chokov, good serve, but easily read by Izquierdo. It's going to come back to her, and that's going to drop in. Choco is stationary, the deflection coming off of Cunha's fingertips and taking it away from the remainder of the team. Gabriel with the serve. Brazilian struggling to get underneath it. Torres Herrera keeps it in play. Got the blank off for Luis Hernandez. And a touch is given against Bodziak. Filho Bodziak, let's see. Well, certainly couldn't tell from there, but the referee said yes, and that's 12-6. Toco! And the touch is out, so the Brazilians hang in this opening set, but they're well down at the moment. Torres Herrera's block going out of play. Going to need a big serve from Roca Ferrero. Mr. Blanco, Gabriel is long, is she? Torres Herrera, rather. Have a look at that again, and yes, I think it was. So the Brazilians hanging in there at 7-12 now, but here's Luis Hernandez. And as is usually the case, her power too hot to handle. Roca Ferrero just unable to get hold of it. And she will be relieved of her duties for the moment. Ana Margarita Alvarez comes on, along with Hela Cesar Rogerio. give you some idea why these Brazilians are putting their Christian names on the back of their shirts. Can't fit into their surname on. From the Cubans just dropping out. So Brazil, Vicunha, Guerreiro, the short set to Cavalá. And they make it look so easy at times. Luis Hernandez then, 12-7, looking to close out this opening set in super quick time. Oh, lovely block from Torres Herrera for 13-7. Cuba then 13-7, looking for the 2 points to close out this opening set. What a block from Torres Herrera. Two on the trot for her to make it 14-7. Look where she was. The huge spike from Choco. She got right in front of it, and the pressure is on again. Play on, says the referee. And Costa Blanco says, thank you very much. We'll finish you off right there and then. 15-7 then. Cuba take this opening set against Brazil. Here we go then, set two, the Cubans up by one. And immediately, Belle McKenzie with a lovely block. We get the first score for the Cubans in the second set. What a beautiful block that was. And managing to do it without touching the net. Chocker on the receiving end of that. And the serve, did it drop? You can see the Brazilians thought it hadn't. And then changed their mind as they saw the decision from the line judge. Cuba with a couple of early points, and that's three now. Well, what a disastrous start for the Brazilians. Alvarez, Margarida Alvarez, and just Ida on the back of her shirt, making a mess of that one. It's going to come to her now. No, it's not. They end up just pushing it over. That's going to put it easy for the Cubans. That's going to drop, and that's 4-0 to the Cubans. Well, the Brazilians in all sorts of trouble here early on in this second set. The Brazilians looking as though they barely won a match, and the Cubans completely dominating them. I don't know if the Brazilians were overawed by playing them, and Carvajal gets up for the block to make it 5-love. Oh, they're going to have to stem the flow here. It's not often that Torres Herrera will serve five straight and get 5 points. And apparently there was a touch on the net. The Cubans don't know why. They won't be undue. Luis Hernandez, a little smile to the side. Here's Choco, Patricia Choco for Brazil. And that's going to go long. Well, the Brazilians at 5-love down can ill afford to give away a service like that. Costa Blanco as the screens come out here at the Nimbabwe Stadium. Oh, great serve from the Cubans. It's going to be Luis Hernandez. Well, how did you find that space from there? Absolutely brilliant. Look where she starts out, and look where the ball ends up. The Brazilians let it go, and Costa Blanco will serve. That serve got a touch on the net as it went through. But the Cubans really well on their way to taking this second set at 6-0. Brazil going to have to stage come back right now. Belle McKenzie, that's in as well. So the Brazilians, after serving through Cunha, immediately take back Belle McKenzie. And the Cubans have found the court with everything they've done so far. Belle with the serve. Little touch from Venturina, the captain, but I think she also got a touch on the net as it went through. Let's see. Well, the serve's gone over, so 7-0, the Cubans lead. Disastrous start to the second set for the Brazilians. Well, a little bit of delight for them, a little bit of relief, as Belle McKenzie's serve goes long. But there can't be too many butterflies in the stomachs of the Cubans now. With a scoreline that reads like that. Hernandez. Well, there's a certain inevitability about what's going to happen when she gets the ball, isn't there? Serve back with Cuba Cavallal for 8-0. Brazilian struggling to get the set up. And there's the block again. 8-0. Oh. Bit of a drubbing the Brazilians are receiving at the moment. We came into this match saying it was going to be a tight affair. And at the moment, it's anything but. And they're making the defense even look very easy. Izquierdo just casually knocking it over. And the Brazilians very precisely setting it up there. Cavaial. Well, they've lost the service, but they don't look too concerned, do they? Cavaial just watching it go in. Filo Bodziak then with the serve trailing 8-0. Izquierdo behind it. Torres Herrera. And immediately the serve goes back. The Cubans. Well, at this rate, this match could be over in less than an hour, if nothing else. Luis Hernandez picks it up, it's going to come back to her. Well, they've blocked her out for once. Williams with a chance to get a point on the board. Guerrero, it will come to Cafael, or look, in fact, Torres Herrera. It looks far, far too easy. The block is a split. The block is surely have got to move across. They should be moving in unison. It's a little like doubles play in tennis. You want the doubles team in tennis, they move in unison to cover the net, and that should be the case in the blockers. The blockers from Brazil really split. And referee saying there was a touch from Bel McKenzie was there. We'll see it again.
The third.
Well, if Brazil can come back from this deficit, I think their coach will pay them a lot of money. Can't see it happening personally, but plenty of things have happened. They just can't get a set anywhere near the net, and that's gone way out from Filo Bodziak. He's got a spike closer to the net than that, and that is the embarrassing scoreline still of 9-0. They really are struggling, the Brazilians. Chotto, easy picking for Luis Hernandez, and that, did it get it? Oh well, Costa Blanco believes it touched. I think it touched as well. And well, it was pretty close. Chocó will get the serve for Brazil anyway. Costa Blanco didn't like it, but as I said earlier, she won't be unduly worried with a scoreline of 9-0. Well, the Brazilians are on the scoreboard. 9-1. Finally, they're there. Crowd giving them encouragement. Encouraging round of applause. Gotto again with the serve. Really huge serve he's got. Guerrero and Bel McKenzie is blocked out as well by Cunha and Venturina. 9-2. Mini recovery here from the Brazilians. Patricia Gotto again with the serve. Prize of Brazil. And that's going to be 9-3. Well, whether there was a lapse of concentration from the Cubans or they really thought this set was in the bag, well, it should be really. Even allowing for this 3-point run from the Brazilians. Huge serving from Gotto. And at the moment, the Cubans struggling to deal with it. Luis Hernandez, well, that really was poor play from Venturina. Where was the call? Is it? You'll see the captain's response after that. Well, we didn't quite see it, but she chastised herself and her teammates because they left so much of a gap on their service. They've won the serve back. Cavaial, for once, considered the world's number one blocker. A block going out. Regina Macia Cunha with the serve. And, well, it looks though it's going to be long, and Luis Hernandez got hands to it, but could only knock it out of play further. 9-4 then, the Brazilians easing back into this set. Cunha serves again. Luis Hernandez, it's Guerrero. And apparently there was a touch, so that's going to be 9-5. And I think the Cubans are called out. Time out here. And for the moment, Junior serving, causing the Cubans all sorts of trouble. And that's 9-6. Well, Brazil really having a run here. They come back from 9-love to 9-6. And Cuba are going to have to wake up a bit here, or they could suddenly be in trouble. But as you know, Marcia Junior serves again. The block is better. They've got a chance to set here. They push it back. It's going to come over from Chokov. Cavayal. And finally, the run is stopped at 6 points. And Cuba will serve 9-6 in front. Cavayal with far, far too much space to aim at. And barely a challenge at the net. Val McKenzie, the left hooker. Venturina, and the block is out, so Brazil will win the serve back off of Luis Fernandez. The spike from Ana Margarida Alvarez, affectionately known as Ida, or Ida. Luis Fernandez making amends for that error on the block. Chokov could only basically crouch and watch it go by. He did again. Well, she got a hand to it. 9-6, the Cubans have tightened things up a little bit. And so the Brazilians, it has to be said. Bodziak, Filo Bodziak, huge frame of Filo Bodziak. 6-9, she will serve. She'll serve as well. Guerreiro having to backpedal, and that's a nice touch. Can the Brazilians keep it in play? Yes, they can. And they've got away with it. So 9-7, the gap is closing all the time, just two now. The Cubans, a little bit at sixes and sevens. And here comes Big Filo. Guerreiro, Torres Herrera, and the block works again. Well, 9-8, what is going on the Cuban side? Torres Herrera perfectly blocked. I said earlier that they were leaving far too much space by splitting their blockers, but they staged a courageous comeback here from 9-love down. Now they trail by the single point. Luis Herrera, and well, it's tied at 9-apiece. Absolutely unbelievable stuff from the Brazilians. 9-0 it was. The Cubans led, and they had literally gone to sleep. And the Brazilians, well, Ericea, Bodziak, Filo Bodziak, as she's known, will be disgusted with herself, having crawled their way back to 9-9. She gives the serve away, but the Cubans finding it difficult to get a decent set. But they do now, and Costa Blanco gets the point. That's their first one in 10. So they lead by 10-9 now. And here is Guerreiro with the serve, and the Brazilian struggling again. Cunha gets it up. Pressure going to come now from Luis Fernandez. What a beautiful bit of improvisation from the Cuban captain. Feigned as though she was going to spike with the right hand, and she just flicked with her left hand, a death touch, back right across the net. Well, it was right, landed right underneath the net. Unbelievable stuff from her. And they go right, and I think it was Costa Blanco once again, so 12-9. So just when the Brazilians look to be right back in it, the Cubans step up a gear, and bingo dingo, we're at 12-9, and the Brazilians call another timeout. Back from 9-love to 9-all, and then suddenly the Cubans show them who's boss, take 3 points, and now stand 3 points away from this set. Torres Herrera thinking that she'd already got that point. Chokov, Chokov again. Touch from Torres Herrera. Good defense from the Brazilians. Chokov. And it's run out. And the Brazilians will have a chance to serve. Venturina, the captain for Brazil. Going to be long, is it? No. Just across to Luis Fernandez. A little tip, but they read it well this time. Set for the Brazilians. What a block from Torres Herrera. Was there a touch on the net? Looks that way. 12-10. Brasilia fighting all the way in this open, in this second set, rather. They really need to take this one. Luis Hernandez just keeping things going. Torres Herrera nearly giving her a piggyback. A lovely block from Torres Herrera. Spike from Cunha. Block from Torres Herrera. 12-10. He will lead with the serve. Luis Hernandez. Good work from Venturina. And Paula Rodriguez got the final touch, and she will take the serve. Guerrero struggling to get underneath it. And Torres Herrera making it look so, so simple at the net. Look at the space, acres of space. You could have driven a truck through it. And Torres Herrera drove the ball through it instead. 12-10 then, the Cubans still those 3 points for this second set, and a two-set to love lead. Great defense. Luis Hernandez calling and Costa Blanco to get there. In fact, it was Bel McKenzie trying to retrieve the ball. The Brazilians have another chance at 10-12 down. Choco, Patricia Choco with the jump serve. Great serve it is too. It's Guerrero, and they've made a meal of that. 12-11. And you can see Carvajal not getting the set she wanted at all, and then trying to spoon the ball over the net. Here's that jump serve again. Did it land in? Yes, it did. 12-all. They've leveled it up again. Well, the Brazilians, Choco leading the way. Look at that for a serve. Right on the line. So Brazil back out at 12 apiece. Can they level it up at one set apiece? They really would love this. Another good serve from Choco. Here's Bel McKenzie. They have some of that. And we'll take the service back, thank you very much. Ortiz is going to come on for the serve to replace Costa Blanco. Costa Blanco not looking too delighted to be replaced at this stage. Tania Ortiz Calabo with the service then. Cuban's trying to mix it up. And that'll be wide, and that's given the momentum to the Cubans just when they need it. Cunha going down the side and misses by about a foot, and that was an all-important miss. Ortiz then at 13-12. Oh dear, oh dear. The Brazilians, what a time to stand and watch the serve go in. Thought it was going long, and it dropped just inside while Ortiz was brought in for the serve, and it really has paid off. And there's the block from Carvajal. Well, after all that, the Brazilians caved in rather tamely. Came back from 9-love down, they came back from 12-9 to 12-all. And then see the set drift away from them. 15-12. Cubans already having destroyed the Koreans. 3-0, well, they stand on the verge. And the Brazilians as well, 3-0. And their last match will be up against the Russians. But the form they've shown so far could take this very, very easily indeed. It's 37 minutes, the quickest match so far in the preliminary rounds. Coming in Tokyo when, yes, once again, Cuba beat Germany. That was the opening match of the competition. Cuba blanking Germany there, 3-0 in just an hour and 4 minutes. Well, they could beat Brazil even quicker here. They have the serve, and they have the first point of this third set. So, 1-love, Cuba. And Captain Venturina is not happy at all, neither is Cunha, number 12 there. Costa Blanco will serve then at 1-love. There you see it. And the referee giving a yellow card to Fernando Venturina, the Brazilian captain. You really have to give some back chat to him. He awarded a yellow card in volleyball. And there's Lima Watson, the Brazilian coach, and he's not happy at all, and he'll get a yellow card if he's complaining as well. Well, everything going against the Brazilians. It's all stacked against them. Costa Blanco waiting to serve. And she will serve at 1-love with the Cubans. 2 sets in front. And Cunha making a mess of the return. And Izquierdo is able to make it 2-0. Great defense from Luis Hernandez, just calling the shot. Cabayao keeps it in play. Got the Blanco set for Bel McKenzie. Brazilians, better defense from them. Hezido, lovely block from the Cubans, and that dropped in as well. Number 4, Margarita Ida, as she's known. Alvarez can do nothing but watch. The Cuban block goes over there, and finally the run stops at 3 points, and the Brazilians get a chance to put themselves on the score sheet. Hope the Blanco will be happy with that opening foray of 3 points. His shot goal for Brazil with a forehead in. Luis Hernandez deals with it, and Bel McKenzie says he's not going to be serving for very long, Brazil, because we'll take over from there. So Bel McKenzie, huge spike from her. 3-0, the Cubans lead. Well, the Brazilians have got to stop the rock somewhere. Cunha going for the return, and nice set, nice spike from her. Acknowledges the high fives from her teammates. Luis Hernandez could do nothing with that. And the Brazilians get on the score sheet in this third set. Cunha serves. Easy for Izquierdo. Got the Blanco. Cabayal, a good block from the Brazilians to put them 1-3 down. There we see, I was talking about getting two blockers in unison together in the centre. They read it better from Cabayal, and they got the two across. Now they've got two this side. Oh, lovely tip from Luis Hernandez. Filo Bodziak, unable to get across to that. Great angle, great touch. Cabayal, deep one from her. And the Brazilians looking a little sharper. Ida Alvarez. She will serve. Set from Costa Blanco. She did really well to get that across to Cabayal. And the Brazilians looking a little dejected at the moment. Cabayal, once again, only one blocker on her, and can't afford that against Carvajal. 3-1, Izquierdo with the serve. Struggling even with the service is Cunha. Hernandez digs it out, and she will go for the spike, and that's 4-1. Thank you very much, Luis Hernandez. Mireia Luis Hernandez makes it 4-1. Huge height, huge speed, and well, we've said it all about Mireia. And that's going to be 5-1 unless he can retrieve that. Well, the Brazilians, things made to look really third-rate against the Cubans at the moment. 5-1. 7-love they trailed. 9-love they trailed in the last set. 5-1 they trailed in this one, and the Brazilians are really up against it now, and that'll be 6-1. Torres Herrera able to put it away. I don't think she barely got off the ground. She was about 2 inches off the ground and just tipped it over. So 6-1, and you can see the Cubans blocking with two wherever they are in the centre of the court. See, they move across in unison, and Luis Hernandez this time will get the block. And the captain, Venturina, I don't think she quite knows what to do to stop this from the Cuban. 7-1, and there's a substitution. Chilene Roca Pelero comes on. But it's looking curtains for the Brazilians. They really are all over the place, and spiking from there, you're never going to challenge the Cubans. Luis Hernandez will make it 8-1, surely. Chocker couldn't reach that. And are they going to call a timeout, or are they just going to walk off? Because this is proving a disaster for Brazil. 8-1. Really expected the Brazilians to put up a tough show against the Cubans, and the Cubans able to block with ease, and that doesn't get a touch on the way through, or does it? No, it didn't. So that's 9-1. And finally they call a timeout. Well, I don't know what their coach can say to them or what they can do quite, but they, at the moment, are being proverbially hammered. They dropped the first set 15-7. They came back well in the second, but still lost it 15-12. That after trailing 9-love and 9-1. Well, they trail 9-1 in this third set, and I don't know quite if they have it in them. And the coach is simply going back to basics and to show them how to dig. Well, it's been a sorry display from the Brazilians. The Cubans haven't really had to get out of second gear. Land a smile, as you can see the banner in the background. Not too many smiles from the Brazilians. Izquierdo serves. The better dig from the Brazilians. Have they got back to basics? Izquierdo. And Costa Blanco's spike is knocked out by Ida. So that'll be 10-1. And this is turning into a walkover. Izquierdo served like this all day. Well, if he's given that one away. Cuban turn. Well, they're almost looking a little dozy. I'm not sure if Izquierdo is in fact awake. He doesn't really need to be against the Brazilians. All looks far, far too easy. Ricerera, up go the two blockers, and you can see the result. And well, it's all very well us sitting up here in the commentary box saying, well, they need to get two blockers up, just like the Cubans. Serve from her, just a little bit too deep. It brings a little bit of... Oh, she can smile about it. You can afford to smile. Two sets to love and 10-1 in the third. If the Brazilians can come back from this, well, I said that their coach would pay them a lot of money in the second set. And he'd eat his hat and do all the other cliche things. Well, now it's 11-1. And surely there's no way back from this. Carl McKenzie. And that ball from Cunha, I need to represent the Brazilians' play. Well, my apologies, it's in fact 10-1 still. And the Brazilians have got a side out. 1-10 down. That was better play. Attacking in numbers. Putting the pressure on the Cubans. And they haven't done that throughout this whole match. It's going to come to Costa Blanco. And, well, they've got a second point. Maybe there's a way back for them. It's a long way back. Surf from Rodriguez. Izquierdo with all the time in the world set. Carl McKenzie is blocked out. And that's better blocking once again. You see the two going up. Carvajal and Costa Blanco. And they win the serve back. Carvajal, it wasn't got the touch. They really do block supremely. Carvajal, the women's premier blocker. Blanco will serve it. And that's better work, faster work from Ida Alvarez. Getting up before the blockers. Toco then at 2-10. With one of her power serves. Must have got a touch, yes it did. Unfortunate for them. And she's their premier server. And Belle McKenzie then. Staring at 5 points for a victory in what at the moment could still be well under an hour. Did it get a touch? Oh, the Brazilians are congratulating themselves, but I don't know that that got a touch anywhere. Well, they've won the serve back. Roca Pelero with the service then at 2-10 still. 8 points to get. Luis Hernandez, Costa Blanco, Cabayal. And far, far too easy. Oh, the Brazilians pushing forward but not backing up. La Tomble comes on for the serve for the Cubans. Carvajal can go off. Well, when you can take your number one blocker off, you obviously are way in front, and the Cubans are. Good serve from her, and that's set up an easy one for Luis Hernandez. The second attempt, makes no mistake. That will lose for us at 11-2. And given just too much time by the Brazilians. And it's going to be another yellow card for the Brazilians. This time it's Margarita Alvarez and the referee, Mr. Dean Turner from Australia, taking no backchat from the Brazilians. Well, he knows the Brazilians are having a tough time out there, but he's not going to accept any backchat from the Brazilians. So once again, La Tomble will serve for the Cubans, now requiring just 4 points for this victory. And that'll be Torres Herrera with the block on Choco for 12-2. Turning into a bit of a lottery. Lassombre, what a substitution that was. Is that going to drop as well? It does, so that's 13-2. Well, we're going for an all-time record in speed of victory here from the Cubans. Got to feel sorry for the Brazilians. They came flying back in that second set. 13-2, there it is. 2 points for the victory. Cunha, can she win the service back for them? No, it's Costa Blanco for Luis Hernandez. And the Brazilians! Well, Margarita Alvarez, who just got a yellow card. Good block from her. There you can see, well, I've said it many times, should be two up, all the block. And Alvarez serves. Here we go, Guerrero, and oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Choco, unable to deal with that. Brazilians really do look a little downcast in this match. Guerrero will serve, just 2 points for victory. And that will be one of them. They've just got nothing right so far, the Brazilians. You saw coach Lima Watson telling them how to receive on these services, but they haven't done it right at all. And is this going to be the winning point? All they can do is flip it over, and it's out. And that is one of the most comfortable victories, maybe even in the history of volleyball. 15-7, 15-12, 15-2, the Cubans have destroyed the Brazilians in 50 minutes, the fastest victory so far in this Women's World Volleyball Grand Prix 1993, and Cuba make it 4 wins out of 5 matches, and they are looking like the team to beat in this Volleyball Grand Prix 93, as I say. The next match will be the final match of this preliminary round in Bangkok when they face Russia. So it'll be the Olympic gold medalists against the Olympic silver medalists. That'll be the one to watch. Can Russia score them much?